Hello friends and everyone, y'all welcome back to Netcode Hub channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to customize screen loader in Blazor WebAssembly project. I have the app created and that's for Blazor WebAssembly. And if I run this, let's see what the screen loader is. Let's check it out and see how to customize one. So this is what I'm talking about. This is the default one. We are going to use the CSS and HTML. Okay. As usual, if you like this video, please give a thumbs up to this video. And also subscribe to the channel if you want to receive more videos on .NET MARI and Blazor WebAssembly or Blazor Server application as well. Let's get to the project. And I'll go to Solution Explorer. And from this www root folder, you're going to see this index, right? Now that is where there is the loader. So it's an SVG, as you can see from here. This is what I am talking about. So you can see from this. So this is what we're going to do. We are going to remove this. Now when we remove this, you save the page. And now you try to reload this. Let's see what happened. Now you can see the page is blank now. Nothing happened here. Let's refresh it again and see. Yeah, so now let's go in there and I'll put in a customizable one. Credit goes to Michael Washington for that. We're gonna use div. Okay, so this is what we need to add. Let's have the CSS style. So with the style, let's instead of putting it over here, let's put it inside the app.css file. So in the same wroot folder and app.css, let's put it down here. The source code of this will be available. So check the description and you're gonna have a link over there. Okay, so it starts from this spinner and it gets up to the last end using this keyframes. Okay, now when you save this and I try to reload this page, let's see what happened. All right, so I hope you've seen this. So this is what I'm talking about. Now this, the first one, you can see how it is loading. Now we can delay this. So let's go to the index, to pages index, and now let's override the page lifecycle of uninitialize. So in here, let's put an await, then tax.delay. Let's delay it by 1 second. So save this. And now let's refresh this, rebuild this and apply. Now let's wait for this to get reloaded and let's see. All right, so you can see we have it set over here. Let's go to the next one. There is just a container class for a bootstrap class and we have the row and our column MD6. So we can center this in the middle. And after doing that, we are going to pass in a div with a class as loader. So you put it here. And now with the CSS, I'm gonna do that in the same app.css and point two. So let's save this. All right, so you can see we have this loader as well. And you can see it is just a loader that we can also use. Okay, so let's go to the third one and see. I'm gonna show you about five loader that you can use in your application. So let's get to the next one. All right, so for the third one, you see, I've commented this as well and with HCSS style. So with this, I'm gonna just make a copy of this and here you're still gonna have the same loader. Now for the CSS, let's have the CSS for this. Now let's go to the same app and now from the third one, I'll just paste in this. So with this, let's remove this outline. And also maybe when you go to this index, that is the index HTML top here where we have this, you can set this empty 5. So margin top as 5. Okay. Now let's refresh this. Yeah. So this is also 1. So this is the third one. You can also use this as a loader. All right. Let's get to the fourth one. Let's have the same copied one. Let me have a space to separate it. You can see we have the same div with this class as loader. Now let's go for the CSS. So app CSS in here, the fourth one, let's paste this. Let's save this. And now let's refresh the page and see. All right, so you see we have this spinner too. So that's the fourth one. Let's get to the fifth one. Let's have the same copy of this. And instead of this class or loader, we're going to add just a simple CSS, inline CSS, to change the color of this. So in here, let's have a style as color green. And in the CSS, let's have the class. So as usual, we go to the app CSS. And now the fifth under, we paste in that. Let's save all. Now let's refresh the page. Yeah. So we also have this loader. So these are the five examples of loaders. All right. So thank you so much for watching this video. And I'm going to catch you up in the next video. Remember that the source code will be available. So check the description. See you in the next video.